I create outstanding patient experiences.
We create outstanding patient experiences. Yes.
Nice.
I create outstanding patient experiences.
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 I create outstanding patient experience.
Back when we became an independent hospital, the Christ Hospital Board of Directors asked us to become a top 10 community hospital. And top 10 in a number of indicators, one of which is patient satisfaction.
What does top 10 mean? Top 10 means that every day when patients and families come to our doors, that our staff recognize the extraordinariness of that experience and that they take the time to not only deal with the technical aspects of their job, but also to make a human connection with our patients and their families in large ways as well as small ways.
It's been a long-standing dream of myself as well as the rest of the executive team to actually hit the 90th percentile and then to surpass it. So to be at the 91st percentile, which is a high goal when you consider it's all hospitals, that's just terrific.
Each and every individual here at the hospital plays a part in creating a memorable patient experience. And patients and families expect excellent clinical care. They expect excellent technical care. But what they judge us many times on is that human, personal interaction with our staff. And so each individual can contribute significantly to creating that experience.
I believe with improving the chances of patient satisfaction, letting patients and their families know that they have our ear and that we're listening to their concerns.
I think the easiest way to describe it is enthusiastic, competent service. And you see that from environmental services to the physicians that treat the patients here.
When they need love like we do, sometimes they need somebody to talk to. We all do sometimes. And it makes them feel better. You know, instead of just going in the room rushing or whatever, I like to talk to them.
I do find that if you find pictures or something in the room, asking people about, you know, their family or their pets, and if you ask them again the next day when they come, when you go back in the room, it always leads right into a conversation with them, which I think makes them feel like, you know, people care and that, you know, you look at them as a person just and not just as a patient.
But when you're on the other end of the spectrum, you know, to feel like that, it's so much better than feeling like you're in these four walls with nothing but needles and blood. When you can take that little bit of, you know, that wholesome feeling from people who care about you getting better.
I think one of the key characteristics that really strikes me in going from floor to floor about the employees and the relationships that they develop with families here in the hospital is just the underlying compassion. No matter what floor I'm on, from the ninth floor down to the cancer center, every aspect of the hospital just seems to be saturated by people who genuinely care for the people that they're taking care of.
We know that patients can go anywhere. There's a lot of choice, and patients don't necessarily know that we have the lowest mortality rates or the best outcomes, but they do know how they're treated when they come to the hospital. And to a patient, that means quality.
Within a three-year period, I was here three different times, three different situations. When I think back on it, the care that I received was sort of a given for me. When I come to Christ, I know that the care is going to be there and I'm going to get the best that there is. But what it came down to that makes a difference was just small things. And in each case, I could think of just small things that a nurse did or someone was able to help me with that made a big difference.
My mom was here. She was in SICU for serious aspiration pneumonia, and I decided that I was going to start walking because I was sitting too much. And one night at 1 o'clock in the morning, I was walking around the hospital, and security saw me walking around your hospital and came up and said, "Do you know that there's a path in the hospital that nurses use to walk a mile?" And I said, "No, I knew nothing about this path." And so he showed me the path that went through endo and down the steps and up. And so I actually lost 5 pounds while my mother was here because security directed me towards a path of walking.
When I was here for the biopsy, my husband was with me, and the nurse, when they took me back, made sure he knew where to go, knew where to get his coffee, and that made me feel good because I knew he was being taken care of.
I was getting ready to leave work one night, and there was a lady that was very distraught out in the front lobby, and I asked her if I could help her, and she said her husband had been transferred from, I believe it was Brown County Hospital, and she didn't know, he should have been here by now, and she couldn't find him. There was no volunteer out front, so I immediately called the operators, who are wonderful, wonderful dictionaries of information for me. They're wonderful, and they helped me go through booking and through everything. I found her husband. She came and saw me the next day and told me everything was really good, and thank you. And then here a year later, she came back, and he had been transferred again, and she came in the shop and saw me, and to come, she said she came to look for me and thank me again a year later, and wanted to know that she knew her way around now, and she could, you know, help herself a little better this time around, and was just really grateful about that.
They'll go the second mile. They'll make things happen for the families that were not asked of them, they were not trained to do, but out of the compassion that is inside of them, they do the small things.
We've had one patient that comes in for ultrafiltration on a regular basis, and her birthday was like 2 months ago, and you know, we got a birthday cake for her and saying happy birthday to her, and you know, different. We do that for a lot of patients actually.
We will paint people's fingernails, anything we can do to make it feel like they're not at the hospital. We love to do that kind of stuff.
I just talk to them, get to know them, ask them how they're doing, if there is anything extra I can do for them. I try to remember a special thing about every patient, as if it's something that they like to have in the morning or something that they like at dinner time.
One of the most rewarding parts of my job is to receive letters, phone calls, conversations in the hallways from patients and or their family members. And the reason for that is that what it tells me is that we have made a connection with our patients and families, and we have made their burden a little bit easier by the services and the care that we have delivered to them.
Looking at the many employees who are recognized by our patients on the survey makes me realize what an extraordinary staff we have. Many times food service employees, environmental services employees, our caregivers are mentioned by name. And the fact that the patient remembers their name means that that employee meant a great deal to that patient.
I just made a phone call today, and the gentleman told me from the moment he walked in the door down on B level from the garage, he said, until he left the hospital, he never met such a courteous group of people. He was just so impressed with how courteous everybody was.
They give them good care. The patients, like when I go and pick the patients up, the patients, they'll say, "Oh, my nurse was nice, oh, my transporter," but they compliment whoever taking care of them.
Well, everybody's very outgoing, kind, willing to help is what I see and notice.
I love coming here. I've never worked with a greater group of people, physicians, nurses, patient care assistants, because it seems like everyone feels that way. We're all very proud of where we work.
And so whether you're, you know, helping with our, your duty is to improve the physical environment or be a highly paid special technician, at the root of it all is letting people know that we care about you as an individual and we're working as a team to further that goal in whatever way we can.
I feel very honored to be able to walk in and to help the doctors, respiratory therapists, the nurses, everybody that's a part of the team, social work, the case managers. Everybody who is so intricately involved knows that if I have an issue, if I have something that is professional, if it's personal, if it's spiritual, somebody in this hospital is going to take time out to sit down with me and help me to walk through those things.
Thank you. As a family member who's had a husband here in your ICU and a mother here in your ICU, thank you for the good service that you gave. But don't rest on your laurels, because there's so much going on in the healthcare field today that needs the personal, enthusiastic attention that you are giving patients.
Understanding that we have a long history of excellence, we also have a long history of determination. What I would expect in 2020 is that we are able to say to our community, we have been the most preferred hospital for 25 years and not just 15.
We know it's a full team effort, and no matter what someone's job is in our organization, at the end of the day, we're serving a patient in some way. So everybody working together has helped lift us up to the 91st percentile. And again, on behalf of the board of directors and myself and the executive team, you have our utmost gratitude.
It's a nice hospital, and you get good care. And it's nice working around the employees here.
I advocate for anybody, if they have to go to a hospital or if they're doing something, it's like, where are you going? You should go to Christ. That's the best.
Of human.